Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to be reviewing the Hornby Family Fun project, but this isn't the actual starter one with all the track and everything. It is their Christmas extension pack. So if I remove the lid, we've got this nice paper that just protects it. In it we get the Hornby J50 number 65469. I'm fairly sure there's only one of these left and it is on the North Norfolk Railway. Then you get two 7-plank wagons, I think. This one is Wharton, I think it says. I'm not too sure, but it's from Leeds. It's a 7-plank wagon and it is number R6758. Then we get another 7-plank wagon. This is Phillips, George & Co, I think that says. And that is number... And this is R6813. Then we also get two Mark 1 coaches. There is one in the British Rail Maroon. And that is number R4629. And then finally we get another one. But this is another British Rail Mark 1. It's in a sort of chocolate and custard livery. And this is number R4630. So, then that is it. In the train pack, it is quite nice actually. I'll see you in a minute. So, now we'll have a look at the detail on this model. As you can see, it is quite highly detailed with a lovely British Rail crest on the side there. It has got a sort of gold banding around the front. And there's one thing that I found very unusual about this, that the dome is closer to the chimney, not in the middle of the locomotive, which is very unusual. Because usually they're in the middle, not close to the chimney. It's die cast. Nearly the entire loco is die cast. So that gives it quite a bit of weight. Quite realistic coal load, but quite nice. Sprung buffers on the tender and on the front of the locomotive. Got a nice pipe here. I think, is that metal or plastic? I think that's might be plastic whistle, but I'm not too sure. But it's quite a nice model. From this angle you can see the cab detail, it's quite good as well. Got a big red reversing handle, throttle and all the other controls for the other parts of the locomotive. And as you can see there, it's got a nice brake handle, just there. And it's quite nice. Turning the locomotive around, you can see the reversing rod here, and it's pretty much the same on the other side, but it's a really nice model in general. As you can see, it's an 060 because it's got zero wheels at the front, six driving wheels and zero trailing wheels, and is probably, I think this is one of the smallest tender locomotives ever made. I'm not too sure. Anyway, let's move on to the running. So I'm just going to show you the slow speed running of this locomotive. That is nice and slow. It's quite a good runner actually, this locomotive. They're quite slow. Just good, because this is a nice small lineup. But if I show you, I turned off the controller and it rolled slightly, so that's quite good. But if I remember correctly, I think this has got a 5-pole motor in it, sorry. So let's get on to running some trains with it. Okay, so let's see the locomotive running. I'm just going to pull it into the station with the Mark 1 coach. Can't pull it all the way through because I've got to be able to run round. Just going to quickly change. Sorry about the hand I've come. Just got to run that round. Just on the Andrew Buckley can read. Oh, the Andrew Buckley is kind of loud. Anyway, the Andrew Buckley has now left. So I can now get the J15 to run around the coach. That's actually quite smooth. Pull it into the runaround siding. Change the point and get it to run around the Mark 1 coach. I actually get it to run quite smoothly as well. Just to show you a nice smooth running. J15. Switch that. And I don't know how I might need to assist. Yes, I will do. That's now coupled up. I'm just going to push the coach into the station so then the passengers can get on and off. And now the J15 can lean. Nice and smooth. Okay, so now I'm going to use the freight wagons from the set. It's going to be a nice coal train. Just pulling in to supply station with coal. Just gonna flip that switch side on my and then I'll there we go. Couple that. Pull the locomotive forward. Then it can run round. And then couple up to the guards van. And then I can uncouple it from the guards van and then it can run the guards van back round to the other side. Oh, whoops, sorry about that. Just made it back up to the front. As I was saying, we can make it run the background to the other side, and then the guard's van is at the other end of the train. Is it going to clear it? Yes, it will. That's good. And then uncouple. Run that round to the other side where I can then shunt the freight wagons. The controller got stuck for a moment. Oh dear. Oh, I think, Coupling's crossed over. Sorry about that. Yeah, the couplings got crossed and then it made the freight wagon do well. Anyway, then it can lean once been unwinded and can be taken back to possibly the colliery to be reloaded and taken to other parts of the country. Then finally, I'm just going to run the Sentinel in with the other Mark 1 coach. Uncouple it. and round. We can take the passengers to another station. Is that coupled? No, it hasn't. Okay, it has not. And then they can be taken off to the other end of the branch line. So that was my review on the Hornby Family Fun Project. I think it's a really good pack for beginners and people who really just want to expand their collection. That's all from me today. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye!